Despite last night's celebrations, Norman Cowan's mum and dad were out early this morning, playing cricket with their other young children in the backyard of their home. The boys, particularly 12-year-old Dwayne, are determined to follow in their famous brother's footsteps. And Father Ivan was on hand, busy giving them the sort of advice he imparted to Norman at the same age. Although he pointed out he really wasn't up to his coaching best today.
Oh, my head is still spinning, but I'm so delighted for Norman.
And what was the party like last night after the amazing English victory?
Electrifying. Everybody was jumping up and things, and it really enjoyed themselves. Toasting Norman, and hope he'll even do better in the fifth test.
But hangovers and the visible remains of last night's party were forgotten when, after many hours of trying, they finally got through to Sydney and their famous son, albeit on a very bad line.
I'm sorry to get you up, but, you know, we're very anxious to speak to you. You didn't get drunk, did you? Did you get drunk?
Mrs. Carnes' typical motherly concern was met by her son's typical reassurance that he'd had a quiet time.
Oh, did you? Oh, lovely. Okay. Bye.
Hi, Norman. Do me a favor. Ask Bob Willis to smile, please. I hope his face doesn't crack. You take care and get 10 wickets on Sunday.
So with that advice to Bob Willis ringing in Norman's ears, the Cowan family sat down to wait for the next test and their son and brother's further exploits. John Ayres in Kenton for Thames News. Just some last note.